Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to bury Latin, not to praise it. Salve, amicis! Ego et Julius, hoc est denunti. As you can tell by my pronunciation, grammar, and word choice, I'm among the select 7 or so billion people who do not speak Latin as a primary language. In fact, everybody says that Latin is a dead language, and nobody speaks it, outside of extracurricular clubs really just designed to show off how smart everyone in the club is. Bacones. But that's not exactly true, as we in the science, medicine, law, and education biz know very, very well. Latin is still regularly used in all of these disciplines, mostly for descriptions of things. So while Latin is definitely dead, it isn't extinct, which is the term we use for languages which have no speakers or continued usage. In fact, Latin is kind of a victus mortis, or a zombie language. It's dead, but lives on in describing animal species, parts of the body, legal principles, debate tactics, and a lot more. But why? Why do we use Ursus maritimus instead of polar bear? Well, the answer is multifaceted, as these things usually are. But let's start with Catholicism. See, around the 4th century, a craze was sweeping the ancient Roman Empire, and all the kids were calling it Christianity. This ultimately led to the formation of the Roman Catholic Church. The church was a huge fan of Latin, largely because that's what the common man spoke, and that was their target audience. Over time, Latin was promoted as being the language of religion and knowledge, and since it was before the age of tweeting, everything written down was pretty dang important. Scientific and medical discoveries, laws, and basically any source of information in the Roman Empire was in Latin. This meant that in order to be part of the educated or religious portion of society, you had to speak, read, and write in Latin. But after the fall of the Roman Empire, Latin was deformalized and broken down into what we know today as the Romance languages. Romance for Rome. This includes French, Spanish, Italian, Portuguese, and Romanian. So why do we use any of those languages to describe laws or bears? One big reason is that dead languages don't move around very much, because they're dead. Latin is frozen in time, and without major populations speaking it, the words in it don't change meaning anymore due to popular usage. For example, we used to use the word dank to describe your cellar, not your memes. But Ursus maritimus will likely always be the Latin name for those carnivorous white monsters roaming around the Arctic Circle, whereas polar bear could be, and probably is, a slang term for a weird sexual act. I don't know, somebody look it up on Urban Dictionary. Actually, don't. And this makes scientific naming and notation particularly standardized, even when we discover new things to be named. All species have a two-part scientific designation, called binomial nomenclature, or its Latin name. The application of these names is governed by the International Code of Zoological Nomenclature, the ICZN, and the International Code of Nomenclature for Algae, Fungi, and Plants, the ICN. The first name is called the generic epithet, and is usually the genus, while the second is a specific epithet, or the species. Sometimes there's even a third name for a subspecies included. So we, Homo sapiens, are of the genus Homo, meaning man, which also includes Neanderthals and other hominids. But specifically, we are sapiens, meaning wise. As a group, we are wise men, and women, of course. An advantage of using a dead language is that it doesn't favor any particular group. It's decidedly neutral, which is great for things like law and medicine. If we call a disease grossitosis, while another culture calls it awesomeitis, you're gonna end up with different reactions by doctors and the public for the same disease. Calling it simply pneumonia removes any confusion or bias. Dead languages might be dead, but just because something is dead doesn't mean it isn't amazing, influential, and widely respected. Like Harambe, whose Latin name is gorilla, gorilla, gorilla. Rest in peace. If you want to know a little bit more about how and why Latin turned into a bunch of other languages and what killed it in the first place, you can keep watching me talk about Latin in this video on Secret Daily. It was only around the fall of the empire that Latin died and these new languages were born. So why did that happen? Well, mainly because Latin is incredibly complex. If you found a new species, what would you name it? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more episodes of D News every day.